2017 marks the 26th anniversary of celebrating business at the Alberta Business Awards of Distinction. Hosted by the Alberta Chambers of Commerce at the beautiful Renaissance Edmonton Airport Hotel, this exciting event brings a diverse representation of businesses from all around the province. The Alberta Business Awards of Distinction recognize businesses and organizations that have demonstrated outstanding achievement and contribution to their community while having developed business acumen and management practices to ensure long-term sustainability.
Welcome your Master of Ceremonies for this evening's program, Peter Brown.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Just a word of warning, that music is way cooler and slicker than I am. Good evening and welcome to the Alberta Business Awards of Distinction. I'm Peter Brown from CBC Radio, and let's start with what just happened. Wasn't that a great reception? That lovely room. Please join me in thanking the staff here at the Renaissance. I'm not sure what to think about this. You're the earliest arriving crowd we've ever had. Usually it's just herding cats out there and you people are ready to go. My favorite is this row, who are nursing their wine. You guys good over there? We're fine. This is the third year the Alberta Business Awards of Distinction are being held here at the Renaissance. I'm delighted to be back, and a bonus for me is that this year I didn't actually have to go out of my way. I was on a flight that landed at about 5, so I'm in the middle of the 8 hours of waiting for my checked baggage to show up at the carousel. So for me, this is great. Tonight we honor people and companies who are distinguishing themselves on two fronts, both equally impressive, business and as members of the community. So they're not only bottom line successes, they've also made great strides in mentorship, in diversity and outreach, among other areas. When people accept awards tonight, you're going to hear wonderful stories about personal passion and commitment and teams of people who really care about each other and their customers. Every nominee tonight has done remarkable work. We congratulate all of you. And this evening wouldn't be possible without our partners, who we'll be letting you know about through the course of the evening. But now, to officially launch this evening's proceedings, please join me in welcoming the chair of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce, Mr. Sean Ballard.
It is my pleasure to welcome you tonight to the 2017 Alberta Business Awards of Distinction. This is a very special event to celebrate the business excellence, leadership, and the contributions businesses make in our communities every day. We're thrilled that you could all join us here tonight to recognize the achievements of each and every one of our finalists. We'd also like to acknowledge that this award ceremony is taking place on Treaty 6 land. The relationship among business and Indigenous communities is very important, and we look forward to recognizing excellence in these relationships later this evening as well. At this time, I'm pleased to welcome the Honorable Darren Billis to bring greetings on behalf of Premier Rachel Notley. Mr. Billis was first elected as the member of Legislative Assembly for Edmonton-Beverly Clearview, on April 23rd, 2012, and again on May 5th, 2015. He currently serves as the Minister of Economic Development and Trade, and previously served as the Minister of Municipal Affairs and Service Alberta. Please join me in welcoming Minister Darren Billis.
I love the music that that you folks have. Wow, that's really loud, isn't it? All right, well, good evening, everyone. And it's my pleasure to join you here on traditional Treaty 6 territory. And I want to begin by thanking Ken Colby and the Alberta Chamber of Commerce for hosting this event and for this invitation and for the good advice and feedback that the chambers provide to me and my ministry regularly. I just wanted to note that I'm joined tonight by the Minister of Municipal Affairs, Shay Anderson, the MLA for Leduc Beaumont. He is a bit of a rock star. Aaron Babcock is the MLA for Stony Plain. And Denise Woolard, MLA for Edmonton Mill Creek. Now, I must start off by saying Premier Notley sends her regrets as her schedule did not permit her to be here tonight. And so bringing greetings on her behalf and presenting the Premier's Award a little later on this evening. I'm proud to say that I'm very proud to be here to the 2017 Alberta Business Awards of Distinction. I'm looking forward to the rest of the evening and let's get it underway. And so your role cannot be understated as far as business leaders. So thank you very much. Keep up the great work.
Thank you, Minister Billis. I have an announcement, and this is exciting. We've created a new award. It's the Instant Feedback Award for people who are ready to identify and solve a problem and to shout out those solutions at a moment's notice. We have a four-way tie between I can't hear you, check the board, share the mic, and Redyevsky. Congratulations. You are problem solvers, and the province is richer for having you. I also wanted to acknowledge a couple more guests who are with us tonight. The Mayor John Whaley from Leduc County is here. Hello, Mayor Whaley. And Deputy Mayor and Councillor Kerry Bauer from the town of Beaumont. Hello, Councillor Bauer. I have just a few more announcements before the awarding begins. We'd like to acknowledge members of the Chambers of Commerce Board and Executive who are with us tonight. Thank you for being here, showing support for outstanding businesses in your communities. Thanks to the many dignitaries, presenters, nominees, significant others, and I would add insignificant others. We've all been there. I would also like, yes, someone recognized a kernel of truth just then. We would also like to take a moment to acknowledge Kelsey Davidson, who is playing the role of Vanna, bringing some glamour to the stage. The dress Kelsey is wearing has been provided by one of this evening's finalists, Virtu Boutique in Beaumont. Also, as you can see, Kelsey is incubating a new project of her own. We wish her the very best on, what's the business way to say this, the launch? No. The rollout? No. Kelsey 2.0? Oh, the new product line. Yes, best of luck with the new product line. If you are an award recipient tonight, you go that way. John will lead you up onto the stage. You go to the X where you have your photograph taken. There's a little more room up front, so if you get swept away and want to do some breakdancing, you can. And also, you don't want to be this guy when you win an award. I was in my garage in 1961, and I had an idea. Fast forward to 1962. Keep the remarks brief if you can. I will award brief award, but that, no, we tried that, it did not work. You can also take tonight off from taking pictures. We have a professional photographer here, so you and your colleagues and family members can just enjoy the moment, as strange as that may seem. You'll be able to see photos of tonight's event on the Alberta Business Awards website next week. You'll find the address in your program on page 18. Digital files of the official photos will be available from event staff. And we've brought our photo backdrop again, so you can create your own photo op. It's in the stairwell just outside the ballroom. Our photographer will be there. And if you have any comments about this evening's events, our roving reporter, Jason Leslie, would love to speak with you and capture your thoughts for posterity is what we're capturing them for. As the evening unfolds, we'll have our hashtags posted on the screen so you can share on social media during the show if you'd like to. And any speech that can be quoted in full in a tweet, I will buy a drink for that person after. Speaking of posterity, we're pleased to tell you this event will be broadcast on Shaw Community Programming throughout Alberta. Once we confirm the schedule, we'll let you know when you can see that in your area. And continuing the tradition from last year, all the finalists will get your very own copy of tonight's event. So you're going to be watching your speech a lot of times. That's why you should keep it short. So that's the business part. Now let's get to some awards. The Arts and Culture Award goes to an arts or cultural organization. It recognizes outstanding achievement and contribution to their community and honors organizations who demonstrate business acumen and management practices that will ensure long-term sustainability. To present the Arts and Culture Award of Distinction, please welcome to the stage Chris Dugan, Chair-Elect of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. It's my pleasure to be here this evening. This award is for the people and organizations who make our communities fun, inspire expression, and help old traditions stay vibrant and even start a few new ones along the way. And it especially recognizes those who take on these important roles with the vision and execution to ensure the contributions they make will continue over time. Now, the finalists for the 2017 Arts and Culture Awards of Distinction are
Rosebud School of the Arts in Rosebud, Alberta. Medalta in the Historic Clay District in Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Grand Prairie Live Theatre, Grand Prairie.
Evergreen Theatre, Calgary, Alberta.
And the 2017 Arts and Culture Awards of Distinction goes to the Grand Prairie Live Theatre Society.
Grand Prairie Live Theatre is a community theatre based in Grand Prairie. We offer a full season of plays and musicals every year. We are currently in our 54th season, and at the end of this year, we are proud to have produced over 300 plays or musicals. We also have a summer theater program for youth that has been going on for 28 years, and due to lots of interest, we were able to expand that program 2 years ago to include full year theater classes for youth. In addition to our theater classes and play season, we also have lots of concerts, comedy nights, we host an annual one-act play festival, we host lots of international, independent, and Oscar-nominated films, lots of workshops for our volunteers, and we host an annual short film festival as well.
Well, what an honor and privilege. I'm Doug Friesen. I'm volunteer treasurer of the Grand Prairie Live Theatre Board. And it's just a great honor to be here representing the theatre. We have 300 volunteers that express their creativity and enthusiasm throughout the theatre season, which ends up being all year long as we run youth drama camps during the summer. And Grand Prairie is a great place for arts and culture. We've been around since 1963, and we've just done our 303rd production. So, again, thank you so much for this award. It's a very tremendous honor to accept it. Thank you.
Congratulations. And it's good to see Grand Prairie win because the Grand Prairie group is usually the fun group. Yeah. Is it just me or looking at the chair, Mr. Ballard, and the chair-elect, Mr. Dugan, does it seem like the chambers kind of have a type? Our next award salutes organizations that embrace diversity in their workforce and create a climate that encourages respect and inclusion. It's the Diversity Leadership Award of Distinction. The nominated organizations don't just talk about diversity as a goal, they also walk the walk. They create workplaces that are truly welcoming, and the Alberta Human Rights Commission is pleased to honor them with us tonight. To present the Diversity Leadership Award of Distinction for 2017, please welcome Robert Philp, Queen's Counsel, Chief of the Commission and Tribunals for the Alberta Human Rights Commission. Mr. Philp.
Diversity is about all of us and the ways we are different. Alberta employers value, respect, and accommodate diversity in their workplaces and in those with whom they do business. It makes good business sense. The Alberta Human Rights Commission, an independent commission of the Government of Alberta, provides assistance with building inclusive organizations and helps resolve and settle complaints of discrimination. Services include a confidential telephone inquiry line, customized educational workshops and presentations, reviews of workplace human rights policies, a comprehensive website, including educational resources, and a searchable database of human rights tribunal decisions. Visit www.albertahumanrights.ab.ca for more information about the mandate, programs, and services of the Commission.
Thank you very much, Peter, and it's great to be here again. I think this is the third time that I've had the honor of presenting this particular award. The video that you just saw pretty much says everything about the commission, and I can tell you as employers, we are happy to come and do individual, personalized group workshops for you. So just get in touch with us if you need that and that assistance, would be happy to do it. Before we announce the finalists, I have to engage in some full disclosure. One of the nominees tonight is Norquest College, and for a very long time, I was a mentor in their youth and youth in transition program. So I hope that doesn't disqualify you, Jody. And it was a great experience for me as well. This is a very important award because it recognizes businesses that go above and beyond. And you all go above and beyond. It's just that you weren't nominated. So, get on it. Okay. But, you know, in the last few months, we have seen and heard reports about discriminatory and hate incidents in communities throughout our province. And those incidents cause me great concern. It's not the Alberta that I know, nor is the Alberta that I want to live in. The Alberta I know appreciates the values of diversity in race, religion, and cultural compositions of our communities. The Alberta I know embraces diversity and encourages diverse, inclusive, and respectful communities. And the Alberta I know respects our individual freedoms to practice the religion of our choice, to love the person we choose to love, and to live freely in an equal and just society without experiencing harassment or discrimination. That's the Alberta that I know. And I'm proud to recognize the nominees for tonight's award. And I think we have a little vignette of each one of the nominees on the screen now. Is that right?
Stantec, Edmonton.
Norquest College, Edmonton Region.
Ambridge, Calgary, Alberta.
Tiny Toes Castle Limited, Red Deer, Alberta.
So you saw those. You saw those four, and those four are all winners, just as all of you are. But tonight's award goes to, are you ready for this? I'm glad I made full disclosure, Norquest College.
Norquest College is Edmonton Region's community college. We're an incredible place. We change lives and we change communities. you know our graduates. We have licensed practical nurses, social workers, and pharmacy technicians in our local hospitals and our community service organizations. We also train firefighters and fire safety personnel. And you hire our graduates in the area of business and in hospitality. Norquest College is a really neat place. 60% of our students are born outside of Canada, representing 134 countries. 70 languages are spoken on campus. So when you visit us, you will have an experience. We're proud of Norquest College, and we hope that you'll stop by.
Thank you very much. Norquest College is honored to receive this Diversity Leadership Award. What an honor. In accepting this award, I'd like to read an excerpt from a poem that was created for the college by two Edmonton poets, Brandon Wint and Nazra Adem. This poem captures the spirit of inclusion of our college. It's entitled Include Me. Open for me the dictionary of your own history, and let us run our fingers over the word home until it bears new definitions in the simple act of being human. Thank you very much.
Congratulations to Norquest and to all of those four nominees. Over the course of this evening, we're going to present profiles of the four finalists for the Premier's Award of Distinction. Here is your first finalist. Please direct your attention to the screens.
Kinetic Target Systems designs, manufactures, operates, and repairs unmanned vehicles as targets for militaries around the world. One of our core customers is the Crown here in Canada, but we do export our product to nations around the world. We have product in over 40 countries. Currently, our main exports are in the Pacific Rim, featuring Japan and South Korea, as well as Australia as our primary exports. We build jet aircraft, propeller-driven aircraft, a couple of different boat offerings, including a 17-foot fast inshore attack craft, as well as a 30-foot work rib used for gunnery training. We have an unmanned ground vehicle used for anti-tank training and sniper training, as well as an unmanned helicopter, which is one of the first in its class.
Now we turn to the Eagle Feather Award of Distinction. This is awarded to a First Nations-owned business that demonstrates outstanding entrepreneurial practices and business achievement while embodying cultural traditions in its operations. To present this year's Eagle Feather Award of Distinction, please welcome Shauna Feth, First Vice Chair for the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
We would love you to become part of the Chamber Network. I mean, once you're involved, it changes your business.
We appreciate all the work that the Chamber does in the advocacy programs and promoting.
It just brings you up to the next level and connects you in different ways you didn't think were possible.
Being a member of the Chamber is a great deal all around.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce, in the best interests of business.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Peter, and happy to say that I'm breaking the type, I hope. Okay, so this award is to recognize business excellence demonstrated by First Peoples in Alberta. It also honors the special contributions businesses can make to all Albertans when they promote and advance Indigenous cultures and traditions in our province. The finalists for the 2017 Eagle Feather Award of Distinction are
Samson Management Limited, Muscuchis, Alberta.
Carvel Electric and Stony Plain.
Mother Earth Essentials Wholesale Corp, Edmonton.
Okay, this is so exciting. And the winner is Samson Management Limited, Muscuchis.
Samson Management takes pride in what it does. We provide management oversight to our businesses as well as those of others. And we provide the same level of quality to ensure their growth and success. We manage profitability alongside with employment. Profitability is important for the sustainability of our employees, but it's not everything. We make sure employees are given the room to grow, to educate themselves, and move up within the organization. We manage our businesses, all of our business, in this manner, and will continue to do so.
Oh, I'm nervous. First of all, I want to thank you all. And it's an honor to accept this award on behalf of Samson Management Limited. And as a leader, elected leader of Samson Cree Nation, on behalf of our chief and council of Samson Cree Nation, our members of Samson Cree Nation who are the shareholders of our company, of our diverse company. And you know, I'm just proud as the president of Samson Management to accept this award. And I also would like to congratulate at this time the recipients forthcoming. Hi, hi. I forgot to mention my name. My colleague says, your name. My name's Holly Johnson Rattlesnake, and my Cree name is Yotinskwew, which is Wind Woman.
Congratulations to Samson Management. Our next award, the Employer of Persons with Disabilities Award of Distinction, honors Alberta businesses that demonstrate creative, leading-edge hiring practices who bring down barriers to workforce participation by training and developing employees with disabilities. To present the Employer of Persons with Disabilities Award of Distinction, we welcome Shauna Miller, second vice chair for the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
Thank you very much. Now we're getting into the Shauna part of the program, so there's a number of us. This award is unique because it recognizes what employers are capable of doing to bring down barriers and helping persons with disabilities experience opportunities that many of us take for granted. What also makes this award special, particularly special, is that it recognizes employers who, through their vision and leadership, advanced appreciation and understanding and inclusion amongst all makes it really important for people with disabilities to get into the workforce. The finalists for the 2017 Employer of Persons with Disability Award of Distinction are
McDonald's Restaurants, Medicine Hat.
South Country Co-op, Medicine Hat.
Goodwill Industries of Alberta, headquartered in Edmonton and proudly serving seven Alberta communities.
Tiny Toes Castle Limited, Red Deer, Alberta.
Shauna was right, this is exciting. The recipient of the Employer of Persons with Disability Award of Distinction is Tiny Toes Castle Limited.
Tiny Toes Castle Daycare is a family-run and family-operated business. We started our program in October of 2010. We provide childcare services to children 12 months of age to 12 years of age. We are an accredited, licensed, and award-winning daycare. When we started our program in 2010, we saw that we were getting a lot of children that came from diverse backgrounds. They were from different ethnic backgrounds as well. So we very quickly realized that we needed to have a workforce that is a reflection of our Canadian culture today. So in early January of 2011, we started our diversity program. We were already getting a lot of interest from staff that had barriers or youth workers or just new Canadians that were new to Canada, and they were looking to use their skills and contribute to, you know, the business industry. And so that's kind of like how our program came into being. We developed and implemented a very comprehensive diversity program.
Hello, everyone.
Obviously, we did not prepare a speech. We would just like to thank everybody, the judges, and everybody for just, you know, giving us this award. We're truly honored and humbled. And well, we started our program in 2010, and it was a bit of a struggle, but you know, we got our program going, and it's going great. And we just hope to continue doing what we do. And thank you, everybody. Thank you so much.
Every year at the Alberta Business Awards of Distinction, we hear from some truly remarkable individuals and teams, as we have already tonight. Their stories of commitment and community are always the highlights of the evening for me. And every year, we couldn't do that without the support of our partner organizations. Now, I'm about to thank all our great partners. And one of the names on that list, I beg you to stay calm, is the Chartered Professional Accountants of Alberta. Easy, easy. I'm just super worried that when I say the name of that group, the Grand Prairie group is going to go bonkers. There's going to be screaming, fainting. There's going to be a mosh pit up here. Please hold it together this year, just once. In all seriousness, we would like to thank our wonderful award partners, and you'll see their names on the monitors. First of all, the Alberta government. I'm warning you, if you applaud for each one, oh, I don't know where this is going to go. The Alberta Human Rights Commission. The Chartered Professional Accountants of Alberta! That was great. Alberta Chambers of Commerce. Easy, they're great, but they're not chartered professional accountants. Our wonderful in-kind partners are FMAV, the Renaissance Edmonton Airport Hotel, the Promo Syndicate, and our supporting partners, Chambers of Commerce Group Insurance. Thanks to all of those partners for making this celebration possible. And now, back to the awards that they have made possible. We hear a lot about the challenging job market for young people, and the minister talked about some of those challenges in the current market. The Employer of Youth Award of Distinction honors employers who are working to improve the situation, creating job and career opportunities for young people. To present the Employer of Youth Award of Distinction, here is Rosetta Taylor, Treasurer for the Alberta Chambers of Commerce. Oh.
Thank you, Peter, and welcome, everyone. There are challenges many young people in today's job market, but there are many employers who embrace the talents and contributions young people are capable of making. What's so fun and inspiring about employers who are taking these steps is the fun they always seem to have while they gain competitive advantage and grow, often in new and innovative ways. So the finalists for the 2017 Employer Youth Award of Distinction are...
Everline Coatings and Services, based in Calgary and Edmonton, Alberta.
McDonald's Restaurants, Medicine Hat.
South Country Co-op, Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Tanitas Castle Limited, Red Deer, Alberta.
I'm the newest addition to the ACC, so the Alberta Chamber of Commerce, and I'm actually really nervous. I know, it's crazy. And the 2017 Employer of Youth Award of Distinction goes to... Everline Coatings and Services.
Not only do we make sure that parking lots look fantastic and that the people are safe and that clients and all their services are taken care of, we also are huge for internal development for our people. So we focus on hiring and developing millennials. It's actually built into our corporate culture where, you know, we actually treat Everline as a vehicle for personal and professional growth. You know, it's a summer job for a lot of students. We make sure that they come back with a lot of learning and a lot of development and that, you know, they feel that they've really learned something. So that's really just been a huge part of the business, and it actually just really contributes to our growth and success because we get the true millennial energy behind our company.
Well, thank you. I always had a kind of a cool idea how it starts something like this, and so it usually starts with a good quote, and to quote a wise man, Macho Man Randy Savage, "Oh yeah!" So, that's good. So it's a great honor from a great province, really unexpected. Congratulations to all finalists tonight. You're all in a higher league of business, even just being in this room. That's something alone to be so proud of. I find that millennials, and I'm sure everybody here, are the future of business. You know, me being a millennial, are the tip of the iceberg in seeing what we can do. Our generation has not only just entered the workforce, relatively, we are just getting started. Everline Coatings and Services is proud to be here tonight to be a representative for our generation. The power of unleashing the resourcefulness, dedication, adaptability, and raw entrepreneurship spirit is real. When you connect them to a higher level of business practices, like Everline's driven principles, great things truly happen in business. Thank you to my team. It was not Alexander the Great who was great. It was his generals. It was the careers and accomplishments that they went on to are not as known, but they impacted the world in a major way. Thank you to this province that's provided an opportunity for my family, for my team's family, for growth and accomplishment in business. And thank you to my wife for being my rock, my pillar. I love you. Let's have a good time tonight. Yeah.
So two things. First of all, he is such a millennial multitasker. He wasn't reading his speech off the phone. He was watching a hockey game while he was doing that. But there's more. I would ask Ms. Taylor to please go back to the podium. The candidates in this category were so closely rated, we have a second recipient.
I know, right? Okay, so I'll just... The 2017 Employer of Youth Award of Distinction also goes to... Tiny Toes Castle Limited.
At Tiny Toes Castle Daycare, we take pride in our youth program. We not only have a volunteering and mentorship program, but we also have partnerships with different agencies in Red Deer. One of our biggest and greatest partnership is with Red Deer College. Their transitional vocational program is designed for students for young students with developmental disabilities. Every semester we get students from their program, and throughout the semester we work with them, whether it's through one-on-one coaching or it's through job shadowing, and we're providing them the skills and the experience of how it is to work with children frontline. And we have been very fortunate because one of our staff who is still currently with us, she joined our volunteering and mentorship program back in 2012, and since then she's still a staff with us.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Alvina, and I am one of the owners of Tiny Toes Castle Daycare in Red Deer, Alberta. Sorry, I'm just shaking right now, and of course, I did not have a speech prepared at all. I would just like to thank everyone that gave us the honor of this wonderful award. Annie and I started our childcare center when we were very young, and we faced a lot of barriers ourselves, being in the childcare industry and having no children of our own. Everyone just looked at us as, you know,
incapable, but we were so happy that we were able to rise above all of our challenges, and now we empower our staff, who also don't have children, but they are wonderful, and we are just so thankful that we have been honored with this wonderful award. So thank you, everyone, and I would like to congratulate all of the other finalists in this category as well. You guys are all wonderful, and thank you so much, everyone.
Congratulations to all four nominees and to our two deserving recipients. It's wonderful to see people's delight, even in their clips, just how pleased they are that their teams are being recognized. When this evening began, and I haven't checked, but cross-border trade was still a thing that was happening. We're going to pay tribute to businesses that achieve success beyond Canada's borders with the Export Award of Distinction, which recognizes outstanding achievement in exporting goods or services outside of Canada. So far tonight, he's brought greetings on behalf of the Premier. Now to present the Export Award of Distinction on behalf of Economic Development and Trade, it's the Minister, Darren Billis.
Say, leave it to the government of Alberta to have the longest video out of anyone's. I'm thrilled to be up here to give this award, the Export Award of Distinction. And this is going to be awarded to an organization demonstrating outstanding achievement in exporting products or services outside of Canada's borders. All right, so the Export Award of Distinction finalists are
Imagination Dental Solutions from Calgary, Alberta.
Kinetic Target Systems, Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Wedding Star in Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Canadian Humalite International, headquartered in Edmonton, Alberta.
And the Export Award of Distinction goes to Wedding Star Incorporated.
Wedding Star is a wedding accessory company. We design most of our products. Probably 90% of the products are designed within our own facility. We try to manage and handle all aspects of our business within our building. Our major partners is obviously the U.S., which is very close to us. We have a few major accounts that use us exclusively, and we also go direct to the bride with our sales. We do have a facility in the U.K. That is a Wedding Star facility. It's a company called Confetti. They reach out to the UK market in the wedding business, and we sell our products through their online site. And from that facility in England, we also distribute our products throughout Europe to other retail stores that are purchasing our products. Along with that, we have a partner in Australia, and they handle all of our sales throughout the Australian market and the New Zealand market. And so with that, and with our main office here in Medicine Hat, which handles all of our sales internationally, we do ship to probably over 100 countries a year.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate this award on behalf of Wedding Star and all of our employees. We've been in this business for 35 years, and when I started, I was thinking Canada. I thought, boy, I was thinking big. It wasn't until we had some U.S. competitors coming into Canada and I started seeing their products on the shelves, and I started to realize that, you know, Canada is a very small market for weddings, that every sale or every dollar I lose, I need to pick it up somewhere else. So I actually started going across the border into their market, into the U.S. And so I was kind of pushed into exporting. So sometimes a bad thing can turn into a really good thing. So I thank them, my U.S. competitors, for doing that. And I just want to say that, you know, for all of you in business, you know, don't wait till you're forced to go into exporting. The world is becoming a smaller place. And I encourage you to look outside your comfortable boundaries. And the world is out there. Thank you.
Congratulations. Congratulations to Wedding Star. That the alternate name for that award is the, oh, so that's how it's going to be? All right, let's do this prize. We're now going to meet the second finalist for the Premier's Award in 2017.
Our senior leadership is very proud of our origins. Dr. Stanley's story is an example of what continues to happen at Stantec day in and day out. I believe that Alberta's entrepreneurial spirit is what made and continues to make what Stantec is today. Alberta is obviously very diverse now. Myself, as an immigrant, I'm very proud to call Alberta home. Obviously, it is not only about place of origin or ethnicity. If you go to any public event, you see diversity all across in terms of age, race, gender. And we see that diversity at Stantec as well. We started to take a very closer look at what that meant and wanted to leverage that diversity through inclusion. And hence, we started to put a lot of strategies and initiatives and programs to make that happen.
So far this evening, we have honored Indigenous-owned businesses. We now recognize businesses that are not Indigenous-owned, but demonstrate outstanding leadership in their relations with Indigenous people and communities. The Indigenous Relations Best Practice Award honors businesses who embrace these relations in many ways, including economic development, employment, training, and community support. Keep your eyes on the screen as we welcome the President and CEO of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce, Ken Cobley.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
There's also opportunities for business, meeting others that need what you do, and also meeting others that do what you need. So there's a ton of benefit there.
We also use the Chamber Benefits Program, the group benefits, because something like that, a business like ours, of our size, wouldn't have access to the rates that we have access to now through the Chamber.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce, where members matter and benefits count.
Hey, Peter. How you doing?
Well, thank you.
You were really good at stirring up the crowd with the applause.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to top you.
All right.
I'm a chartered professional accountant and darn proud of it. Thank you.
Can you see the wave? Come on.
Not done yet. I was born and raised in Medicine Hat, Alberta. I've lived in Beaumont for 40 years. This year's AGM of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce will be hosted by the Leduc and District Chamber of Commerce. And this is going to be the loudest of all of them. Next year's is going to be hosted by Grand Prairie Chamber of Commerce.
What's that?
Yeah, and my wife does drink red wine on occasion.
All right.
This award is to recognize the leadership of businesses who value relationships, and in particular, recognize the special importance Indigenous people play in all our lives and communities. It also recognizes that there are many ways to value these relationships, to be inclusive, and to form strong connections to the communities they serve and work with. And the finalists for the 2017 Indigenous Relations Best Practice Award of Distinction are...
CN Edmonton, Alberta.
Civio Edmonton, Alberta.
And the recipient of the Indigenous Relations Best Practice Award is CN.
CN is a backbone of the economy, and we operate within or adjacent to approximately 200 reserves of 110 First Nation and Métis communities in Canada. Dozens of these are in Alberta. we developed a vision at CN, and our vision is to have respectful and mutually beneficial relationships with all Aboriginal people while ensuring service to our customers, to be viewed as having a sound engagement with Aboriginal people and having respectful and sustainable relationships across our network. CN believes that strong relationships and face-to-face communication is essential with our neighbors.
Wow. Good evening. My name is Melanie Allaire, and I'm really proud being the leader of that team of the Aboriginal relations at CN. First of all, I would like to acknowledge the traditional territory of the Confederacy of Treaty 6 First Nation, on which traditional territory we're gathering tonight. This honor is a recognition of the amazing work of passionate and dedicated people that I have on my team, including Doug Devlin, who's actually Senior Manager Aboriginal Relations for Alberta to Ontario. As Doug said in the video, CN really decided in 2013 to adopt its Aboriginal vision and really to go from a reactive mode to a proactive mode, including business opportunities, employment, addressing claims, issues before they are actually becoming a problem. Actually, we've developed also a cultural awareness training for our employees to demystify what it is to engage with our Aboriginal communities along our right of way. So thank you very much for this recognition. Thank you to the Alberta Chamber of Commerce. This is a great recognition of the great work. Thank you.
Congratulations to CN. In the age of brand marketing and social media, our next award honors companies that have used innovative and effective marketing strategies to promote their businesses across many platforms. To introduce the finalists for the Marketing Award of Distinction, please welcome back Sean Ballard, Chair of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
I get my marketing tips from Jonathan, who tells me that when I stand up, I should button my suit, and when I sit down, I should unbutton my suit jacket. So this is my marketing leader. The Marketing Award of Distinction recognizes businesses that develop and implement successful strategies, marketing strategies, strategies that show significant impact on their business. The finalists for the 2017 Marketing Award of Distinction are
Annie McGuire Interiors and Design Studio, Inc. in Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Active Physio Works, located in St. Albert, Fort Saskatchewan, and Edmonton.
The Alberta Construction Safety Association in Edmonton.
Westcan Bulk Transport, head office, Edmonton, Alberta.
The 2017 Marketing Award of Distinction goes to the Alberta Construction Safety Association.
So the ACSA has been around for almost 30 years now. We started out as a spin-off from the Alberta Construction Association to address some of the safety concerns that had been identified at the time. And the original board, which was a lot smaller than the current one, decided that we should have a temporary logo just so we could move forward. That temporary logo was never changed. So now here we are 30 years later almost, needing a new logo because the association has changed so much. We have a leadership position across the province in the safety sector and also across the nation. Our NCSO designation, National Construction Safety Officer, is now being adopted by all of the provinces across Canada. We have a Health and Safety Advisor designation, which will also be going national shortly. And we have 13,000 safety leaders who have been qualified by us across the province. And just recently, we educated our 1 millionth individual in safety training. So we've come a long way from where we were originally 28 years ago.
Thank you. I just realized I'm wearing the same shirt when we were doing the video. This is for 60 very dedicated people at the ACSA who support 62,000 member companies across Alberta, 13,000 safety leaders in the construction industry. And we've been doing that for 28 years. And finally, we have a real logo, not a temporary logo. But there's four people who were very instrumental in making that happen. Zahara Elmi and Alicia Hewitt from the ACSA, James Morrissey and Valerie Goulet from the Met Agency who did the creative work and truly worked their butts off. Very proud of the team that we struck. Also, I'd like to acknowledge four other people, our executive director, Dan McLennan, our chairman of the board, Stephen King. I probably got that in the wrong order. Sorry, Steve. Our chief operating officer, Tammy Hawkins, and our external advisor, Sharon Bell. The four of them formed our advisory committee who gave us great guidance and helped us bring this project along. On behalf of the Alberta Construction Safety Association, thank you very much.
Congratulations. Now, ladies and gentlemen, turn your eyes to the screens once more. We're about to meet the third Alberta business in the running for the 2017 Premier's Award.
Opening a funeral home in Alberta is certainly a big undertaking, but we felt really well supported to do that in our province. We opened our first business about 20 years ago and have had to use some of the supports, even the supports that the province itself has, some of those programs. And we've never been disappointed with what's been available to us. We find that this is a great province too, to be able to connect and find people that really want to help each other along the way. We've never lived in another province. We didn't have to move to Alberta to do this, but we really find that if you have just a nugget of entrepreneurial spirit in you, you're really going to want to be able to exercise that, and this is the perfect place to do it. We're happy to be Albertans, and we're happy to be entrepreneurs in Alberta.
Our next award is for small businesses. You can spot the small business owner operators in the room. Those are the ones that, when the mic didn't work for 20 seconds, were like, that's 20 seconds, I could have been dealing with a work thing, come on! The finalists for the Small Business Award demonstrate the highest levels of personal and professional passion. They combine a dream with endless hard work in their commitment to make their businesses succeed. The Small Business Award of Distinction is made possible, guess who? The Chartered Professional Accountant of Alberta. 4 more years. Here to congratulate this year's finalists and present the Small Business Award is Rachel Miller, Chief Executive Officer of CPA Alberta. Let's hear it.
Thank you. I knew this was one of my favorite events to attend. Thank you for the very warm welcome. Our next award is for small businesses, but there is nothing small about their visions and their accomplishments, or for that matter, their commitment. The finalists in this category have combined their big dreams with hard work to build successful businesses. They've provided valuable products and services to Albertans, and they've made significant contributions to their communities in a variety of ways, which include raising funds for student scholarships, organizing events for seniors, helping new Canadians find work, and so much more. These organizations truly exemplify innovation, leadership, community involvement, and entrepreneurial spirit. The finalists for the 2017 Small Business Award of Distinction are
LA Chefs Catering and Events, Lethbridge, Alberta.
Microengineering Tech Inc., Calgary, Alberta.
Cornerstone Funeral Home, Lethbridge, Alberta.
ViewTrack Technology, Inc., Edmonton.
Bear Creek Funeral Home, Grand Prairie and Fairview.
And the 2017 Small Business Award of Distinction goes to ViewTrack Technologies, Inc.
Five years ago, when Ted Parr and myself took over ViewTrack, it was really to show our shareholders, people like Brett Wilson, what we can do and how we can turn around businesses. But as soon as we got in, it changed. And the right reason why it changed is because we met our customers, the producers, their family people, they're proud of what they do, and they need a little help to tell their story. And so we provide the technologies that give them the ability to tell their story so that people around the world and in Canada can know the amazing food products that they put together that we get to enjoy every day. And we can be part of that partnership with them always.
Oh my God. I almost put that same suit on. It's in my car. But I have to admit, I think I made a wrong career decision because growing up, my dad says, you know what, son, I would love to have you become a CA. And I didn't. So I apologize, Dad, and the CPA Association. But I don't know what to say. It's such an honor to win this award. And quite often, when people say, oh, you won the award, you know, you deserve it. So, tonight, I want to make sure everybody knows I don't deserve it. My staff do. The people who work tirelessly, they come to work every day with their A game. They bring in the ideas. They collaborate. They work together. They look at how we can serve our customers better, how we can serve the planet better. And then they take that energy and bring it to our strategic partners and grow those relationships so that at the end of the day, we're always delivering what is most important in our hearts, which is traceability, food safety solutions around the world. And I asked Deb to come up with me tonight because, you know, in our industry, in the agricultural industry, women often have to fight an uphill battle. And here's a lady that I deeply respect because not only has she done that, she has been on top and she pulls me to the top with her. So I want to say thank you, Deb, for always being there.
You're
with
welcome.
Us and being part of the team. And just that, I'm just so honored to be able to work with somebody like yourself. And we have a whole team of individuals, much like yourself, who are all winners. And that's what this award is about. And thank you so much, everyone.
Congratulations again. Which leads us perfectly to our next award, which recognizes success on several fronts. The Woman Entrepreneur Award of Distinction recognizes women entrepreneurs for leadership, innovation, sustainable business practices, commitment to the community, and an awareness of cultural, social, and environmental concerns. So only the seven things they have to do well there. Returning to the stage to present the Woman Entrepreneur Award of Distinction is Shauna Feth, first vice chair for the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
Sometimes somebody does have to speak up and advocate for a certain direction, whether it be economically or politically, and the Chamber is one of the organizations that does that.
It's a really good support network in terms of learning, development, and just sometimes camaraderie.
It's a diverse group in both age and gender and also in business styles.
The Alberta Chambers of Commerce, where members matter and benefits count.
Thanks, Peter. This is an award that's near and dear to my heart as well. And as Peter notes, women entrepreneurs often do have a few more boxes to tick off to get recognized for their successes. Far more important than criteria details is the intention of this award, which is to recognize the achievements of women as entrepreneurs and the contributions they make as business leaders in our communities and to our economy every day. The finalists for the 2017 Women of Entrepreneur Award of Distinction are
Minuteman Press Leduc, Leduc, Alberta.
Virtue Boutique, Beaumont.
Kids Uncomplicated, Edmonton, Alberta.
The Pooch and Pony, Stony Plain, Alberta.
So exciting. And the winner of the 2017 Women Entrepreneur of Distinction Award is Kids Uncomplicated.
I guess I want people to understand a little bit more about social entrepreneurship. It's not the same as being a not-for-profit. In order to be able to make a big impact in health and education and to scale our ideas and our services globally, we need to leverage our innovations. We need to make money to be able to build those innovations and scale them. And I think absolutely women can lead the charge in some of those areas. And I think that we can build technologies that help people and make money that are absolutely in alignment with our values as Albertans and Canadians.
Thank you. I am honored to accept this award on behalf of our outstanding staff, our shareholders, our mentors who are here tonight, and certainly the families and the children that we serve. It's absolutely an honor to be acknowledged as one of Alberta's finest businesses, certainly to represent women entrepreneurs in this province. Congratulations to the other finalists. Kids Uncomplicated serves our most vulnerable children and families, those with disabilities like children with autism. We are proud that our innovations, our technologies, and our outcomes are gaining international attention. We believe that we have part of the solution to one of the world's largest problems in health and education today, which is sustainability. We absolutely can achieve patient-centered care, quality support and outcomes, while achieving efficiencies. We look forward to the upcoming months and years as our services and Teleroo technologies scale globally. And I am proud to say that innovation is alive and well in Alberta. And so stay tuned for more. Thank you.
Now we meet our fourth and final finalist in the running for the 2017 Premier's Award.
So Evergreen Theatre is a company in two parts. One, we're a theatre for young audience company where we provide programming about environmental and science-based topics to children and youth across the province. We have a touring show and a residency program. So we teach environmental and science-based topics through the lens of theatre. And then the other side of our company is our spaces side. So we have a building over in the northeast of Calgary. It's 24,000 square feet, and it has 7 studios and a theater. So we provide affordable space for Calgary groups to have performances and dance classes and whatever they need space for. So it's quite a diverse space. We also try and encompass environmentalism in our practice. So we have our space is a reclaimed gym, and we did a whole bunch of refurnishing on it. We just replaced the floor in it, and the person who took away the floor is turning it into new furniture. So everything gets reclaimed, everything gets sort of recycled, and we really try and embody our company's values within our model and practice of business.
I just remembered that there was something I was supposed to announce at the beginning of the evening. And I'm sorry to be announcing this without the string music that has underscored everything tonight. Ba-da, da, da, da. Somebody found this earring upstairs. Ba-bang. So if it's your earring, come claim it. It's way more exciting with the strings, isn't it? And now the award that celebrates brilliant business acumen combined with a level of youth and confidence that makes me feel like a sad old man. The Youth Entrepreneur Award of Distinction recognizes success in business combined with significant social, cultural, and environmental awareness and a commitment to community. To present the Young Entrepreneur Award of Distinction once again, and for the last time tonight, here is Chris Dugan, Chair-elect of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. First, I can't let an earlier
comment you made earlier this evening, challenging the perceived, perhaps on first blush, lack of diversity within the ACC executive between Mr. Ballard and myself. Yes, indeed, we are twins. Twin brothers from different mothers. However, at the ACC, we are proud of our gender diversity at a 50-50 ratio on the ACC executive. So thank you. As with all entrepreneurs, there will be a story of hard work, commitment, and vision behind each of these nominees. Now, the businesses they start show excellent potential for growth, and as people, they often demonstrate leadership far beyond their years. Now for the unscripted, as an individual who finally found the stones at the age of 40 to bounce into the entrepreneurial world and has managed to thrive, message that I could add is, ladies and gentlemen in this award group, anticipate failure, embrace the pain, and enjoy every single moment, because this is where the true lessons are learned. It's a two steps forward, one step back world. No matter what anybody else tells you otherwise, that is the way it is. It's nature's course. Don't try to fight it. Grow from it, and again, enjoy every minute of it. Now, the finalists for the 2017 Young Entrepreneur Award of Distinction are...
Integrity Post Structures, Okotoks, Alberta.
Plush Salon and Spa, Medicine Hat.
Oil Country Towing, Leduc, Alberta.
And again, I can't say enough about the admiration that I and many others have for young entrepreneurs that do have the chutzpah, as they say, to take the plunge. But tonight's award winner, Young Entrepreneur, Integrity Post Structures Limited.
Being a finalist before for the Young Entrepreneur Awards, I feel as though our business has really grown since then, just the realization of what that did for our company the first time around. The second time around is just another great pat on the back to our business, showing that, you know, we weren't just a one-time thing. We continue to grow, we continue to excel in the business that we're doing, and we continue to change the industry that we're involved in. It's really special to us.
Thank you. Truly honored to be an Albertan tonight. Can't speak right now. I wanted to obviously thank the girls at the Okotoks Chamber of Commerce for supportive cheering in the background. And obviously in the spirit of entrepreneurship, competitiveness, I want to win the next award for getting off the mic as quickly as possible.
Nice. Somebody cheer those guys up. I don't know if we can do this. Can you play the walk-on music again? The earring. Lost. Who's mysterious? Oh, there it is. Thanks, guys. That was the version that got results. We have arrived at the Premier's Award of Distinction. This is like Best in Show at the Westminster Dog Show, and the winners will do that happy trot up and down the aisle if you give them treats. The Premier's Award of Distinction is presented to the Alberta business that best embodies the Alberta advantage. It shows singular achievement and leadership, as well as ongoing involvement with the community, locally and provincially. To present this year's Premier's Award on behalf of Premier Rachel Notley, please welcome back the Honourable Darren Billis, Minister of Economic Development and Trade.
I thought
thought we were going to show that fancy GOA video again. So, unfortunately, you don't get the premiere tonight. You're stuck with me, but I thought four is better than one, and so I'm going to invite up the Minister of Municipal Affairs, MLA Babcock, and MLA Wooler to help me present this award. Besides, an opportunity to show off Minister Anderson's beard is, I think, yeah, let's have a round of applause for his beard. So a couple things I just wanted to say, and I expect a big cheer from the Grand Prairie folks, but I was just up at Growing the North yesterday and the day before and met a second 8-year-old entrepreneur. I met one a month ago in Wetaskiwin, and a young girl named Sammy Jean, who's 8 years old and is a member of the Chamber of Commerce up in GP and has a successful business. And so, you know, truly inspiring. All right, I want to read one quick quote from the Premier, that business leaders being honored tonight truly epitomize the best of Alberta by displaying vision, innovation, inclusion, and community building. And this award is truly, as Ken told me, he said, this is the best of the best. And what's unique about this award is that all of the folks from all the companies from all the different categories are eligible for this award. So if you won an award already, you may get a second. And so very pleased to present the finalists, which we've already seen, but we're gonna see it again.
Kinetic Target Systems, Medicine Hat, Alberta.
Aesthetic, Edmonton.
Bear Creek Funeral Home, Grand Prairie and Fairview.
Evergreen Theatre, Calgary, Alberta.
All right, let's give them another round of applause. And the winner is the recipient of the Premier's Award of Distinction is Kinetic Target Systems.
Kinetic Target Systems does business in Alberta for a number of reasons. First, our partnership with DRDC Suffield allows us access to controlled airspace. This allows us to develop our drones in a safe and controlled environment. The business environment in Southeast Alberta allows us to remain competitive globally. We build a lot of boats here on the prairies, and while that might seem odd, we can do it in a much more cost-effective way than if we were established on the British Columbia coast. Finally, the access to engineering services and engineers themselves from the University of Alberta and the University of Calgary allows us to recruit world-class engineers and keep us competitive, delivering the products our customers want.
Wow. I am truly honored, surprised with so many great candidates, all of you. But I absolutely have to thank the staff that we have back home in Medicine Hat. A week ago, we had, I think, four of us planning on attending, and today I had the privilege of having my husband come as my date, because the reality is that our staff, the ones that had planned on attending, one is taking advantage of the programs that he was spoken about and is in Australia, taking advantage of trying to take our targets and move them into that economy. We've also taken advantage and been in Chile, et cetera. We have right now, there's only 45 of us in our small shop in Medicine Hat, but we have 11 of them in two different programs operating for the US Navy right now. Hopefully destroying our targets. So it's a great business to be in, to be able to blow things up. It's a good strategies all around. So again, I am truly honored and thank you very much.
Congratulations to Kinetic Target Systems and thank you to Minister Billis. We have one more prize to give out before we wrap up, when the Chambers of Commerce put out their call for nominees, they threw in an incentive. They offered to give away 2 iPads to both a nominated business and the person who nominated them. If everyone in your office is too focused and productive, iPads will take care of that. We drew the winners' names prior to tonight's celebration. The winners of the 2 iPads, and if you feel like it, you can make acceptance speeches. Marcy Stickle from LA Chefs Catering and Events, and the Lethbridge Chamber of Commerce. Come on up and claim your iPads if you are Marcy or the Commerce Chamber. I can even have photos taken if you want. I'll do it. This is Marcy's first random draw and her first win tonight. Oh, the problem solvers are yelling, redraw! On behalf of the Lethbridge Chamber of Commerce, I'd like to thank, man, the whole team. Just the way they randomly put our name in, and that's what it's all about. That wraps up the 2017 Alberta Business Awards of Distinction. Thanks to all of you for joining us. This is such a great night every year. Thanks to everyone working in the current climate to build a great future for Alberta businesses. Lots changed in the 5 years or so I've been around this event, and one thing that has not changed is just the spirit and remarkable work and commitment of all of the businesses who are recognized tonight. Congratulations to our splendid finalists and award recipients. This evening is a great reminder of everything you do to keep Alberta strong. Let's give one last round of applause to all of this year's finalists. On behalf of the Alberta Chambers of Commerce, I would like to invite you to join us in the lobby outside the theater for after-show dessert and refreshments, photos and schmoozing, and live music by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Alberta. Have a great evening, and we'll see you next time.